Hey guys, so I am back and I'm doing an unboxing. I finally got my heat press from Heat Press Nation. It is the HPN Signature Series, a 16 by 20. I'm like sweating. Let me tell you, okay? This bad boy is heavy. So I'm going to actually unbox it with you guys. I'm so excited for this heat press. I've been waiting for it. So I have a heat press, right? Let me tell you, if you have the money, this came to, like, I live in New York. It came to $769.18 with the tax, and it got delivered here. I think it's six something for this heat press. If you can start off with a heat press, a good one from the beginning, if you can invest in it, I would suggest that, okay? Because I got this heat press. Let me tell you. This heat press from Amazon, okay? I think it was $288 and change. It's a 5-in-1 and a swing away. And it has a pull out, okay? It has a hat press, mug press, plate press, and then the regular heat press. So hat, mug, plate, regular press. They said it was a 5-in-1. Maybe it's a 4-in-1 swingwear. That could be what it is. Okay. My problems I've had with this heat press is unbelievable. And that is a 9 by 12, I want to say. So first of all, it's a small one. If you are going to be doing any type of business with heat press, shirts, hats, get the big one to start with, because the small one is never going to do enough. You're never going to have enough space. Secondly, this one, when you pull it out, it has black gunk. I've tried to clean it so many times. It gets on my shirts. I made pillows. It got on that. Nasty. And the top of it, when you keep pressing it, pulling it up and down. Let me see if I can show you what I mean. So this piece under here always comes unraveled. So this whole thing falls off of here. Falls off. It's not very, look, it's very wobbly. It's not made very well. And it doesn't keep the heat, first of all, okay? So I have to press things a lot. And the shirts get burned, like a yellow mark around them, because I'm holding the press down too long. And the plate press is okay. I did a couple of plates for Christmas. And mind you, I had this since October of 2019. So October, November, December, January, February, March, April, May. Would be in April. So I had like 7 months. The plate press is alright. I did a few for Christmas. It was okay. The mug press already broke. I know it's an unboxing, but I'm just gonna tell you my dilemma that I had with this press. That's why I got this one. Now, when this heats up, it puffs up and it doesn't even, like, you can't even slide your mug in it. So when I do press a mug, I have to slide the mug inside of it while it's cold, not even heated up. And then I have to heat it up inside, like, already with it closed and pressed. That's so bad to do, because then you have heating problems. So I did a mug. I'm going to show you. Okay. So from afar, oh, cute. It looks so nice, right? No. So you see the middle is all light. I don't know if you could tell, but this is all light. This is kind of pressed dock. This is pressed dock. So it looks okay. I mean, I'm not going to sell it like this. Someone will use it. I don't drink coffee. I was just doing some quarantine stuff. Yeah, so that's my dilemma with the mug press and with the press itself. First of all, it's not big enough for the stuff that I want to press. Secondly, when you pull it out, the pull-out draw, show you. For anyone who doesn't have a heat press or they're looking for a heat press, this one has a pull-out draw that I just took out too much. Anyway, and that's another problem too. When you pull it out, it falls right out. Like, it doesn't stay on. So anyway, so it has a pull-out drawer. The top of it to do the top and the bottom to make it medium press, heat, you know, tight press, whatever. So, and then it doesn't keep the heat. I don't know. It wasn't worth the money, and I wish I would have just saved up the money and bought a nicer press for half the money. Well, not half the money. Half the time of my aggravation, because it's very aggravating. When you get something and you think it's going to work good and you have a lot of orders to fill and then it doesn't work good. And then not even 7 months down the line, it ends up like going down the tubes anyway. So I hope this one's better. I've heard that a lot of people get heat presses from Heat Press Nation and they're supposed to be really good and they're supposed to last long and all this and that. So this one has a pull-out drawer and it's a 16 by 20. And I believe it's an auto pop-up. Maybe it's not. I think the auto pop-up was like 1,000 something. Anyway, I don't need all that fancy. I just wanted the pull-out because it's a clamshell, so it just lifts up. It's not a swing-away. I tried the swing-away, and I'm going to be honest, I don't really like the swing-aways. So let's open this bad boy up. And it's heavy. Did I say that? It's heavy, okay? So I've been stalking the FedEx people. And when he came today, I was like in my pajamas. I was like, oh my God, FedEx is here. As soon as I seen him with the dolly, I already knew it was my heat press. So I ran upstairs to get like a couple bucks to have him bring it in the house. And my garage was open. And he left it in the garage. I was like, no! So I had to push it through the garage, up the garage stairs, inside the house. Push it from the back of my house all the way to this, my back office. So, I can't breathe that well, and that's one of the reasons. Whew. Okay. So, yeah, plywood. This is actually a nice piece of plywood. Save this. If you're a crafter or something, this is really nice. It's thick. This is a nice piece of plywood. You can use that for something. I won't be saving that. All right. Yep. You can tell this is heavy. So I'm going to move this one. This is out of here. Styrofoam. This is nice styrofoam too. Like, not the cheap kind. So if you ship something and you need styrofoam, save this. I like to save everything. Save this. They call me the mini hoarder. That's good styrofoam. Look at this. Oh my gosh. Okay. So here's Signature Series, owner manual. I tried to get their mug press, but it was going to take too long to get here, and I'm so impatient. I'm so dumb. I should have just did it. Because it's on a pre-order. And I was like, oh, I'll find somewhere else because that's going to ship it faster, but I should have just did it. I'm kind of regretting it now. Oh my gosh. Satisfaction guarantee. Hopefully I don't break my back. Let me show you what it looks like inside the box. Mm-hmm. Look at this bad boy. It's in there. See this? And this is not... This is heavy. Like, this is really heavy. Oh my God. Why do I do this to myself? Okay, so I'm gonna just move this over a little bit. I gotta take my glasses off because I'm already feeling myself getting hot. Okay.
I finally get it tipped over, and looks like it came with some knobs there. The last piece of plywood is screwed onto the heat press, so that's what you're gonna see me doing. Getting my screwdriver and unscrewing it from the heat press. Again, this thing is super heavy, so you're probably gonna need someone to help you pick it up and put it where you want it to be. It's about 140 to 150 pounds, I believe. I mean, that's how much I weigh. So, yeah. If you wanna be picking up a whole extra person by yourself, I wouldn't suggest it, so definitely ask for some help. Okay, so I did it. I finally took all the screws out of the piece of plywood on the bottom of the heat press. So now you see me taking off the plastic and attempt to pick it up. My son actually comes to help me out to pick up the heat press and put it on the table.
Sorry, we are trying to figure this out. Okay, I'm gonna go sit back down.
All right. Oh my gosh, son. I don't know if you saw the struggle, but I had to pick, have my son help me, and we call him, I don't want to say he's staring at me. We call him Dr. Bones, because he don't have much meat on him. But if he helps me carry it. Let me tell you, okay? No. I'm pretty strong, okay? You're going to need someone to help you pick this up. All right, let's look at this beauty. It didn't even fit on my table either. I had to like maneuver this around. All right. Okay. This is big. Just make sure it's sturdy in here. That's big.
Very big. My goodness. My gosh.
I've never had a 16 by 20, obviously, you can tell, because I said it's really big, so. Cut off the zip tie.
Plug it in.
I'm not gonna plug it in just yet. I want to read the directions first. Real quick. Because something, these are supposed to go somewhere. I have no idea where. These and they go on the bottom. They go cutting that out. So they go on the bottom. You can see holes right here on the end. That's where they go, on the bottom. I am going to do it because I don't know if you have to have them up on them. And I also just skimmed through the directions. I'm gonna fast forward through all the mambo jumbo. Which means nonsense. As I almost died, my ring light almost fell on my head and killed me. My son is sitting right in back of me, and you think he would like say, "Mom, you okay?" He just laughs. Isn't that nice? Don't I have a nice child? Okay, so I am going to do this and fast. All right, so I got it up on my put my glasses on because I'm blind. Hello. Okay, so I got it up on here. I put the knobs on the bottom. As you can see, I did in the back. The only thing is, I'm a little iffy about it being on this table. Look how it rocks. When you open it, look how smooth. That's like smooth compared to the one I have. Look at this. Doesn't come off. This is nice. I don't know what this sleeve is on here, but I'm keeping it on. That's really nice. The only thing is a little dusty, so I will clean that back there, but it sounds like a drawer. You know, but I don't like how it shakes. See, put it down. That's so nice. I love this already. I think this will fit on this table. I hate to move it because I love my setup with my Cricut and my laptop and everything's just like boom, 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 you know? But I also want to be safe. And I do have kids around here, and if I'm working here and they're running around or whatever, I don't want them to be in an unsafe situation. So sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. So I might have to just do a little switcheroo here. I might just have to change my Cricut machine to a different spot. Dang, much better. I feel like this is much more stable. Let me see. Yeah, I feel like that's better. It's not on a rickety table. It's good. I don't like it here, but what you gonna do? All right, so this is the unboxing of the Heat Press from Heat Press Nation, HPN series 16x20 with a pullout drawer. No auto open, I thought it did, but it doesn't. Which, I mean, I think it's fine. I'm going to come back with another video. I'm just gonna turn this on. No, I'll wait to turn it on. But I'm just gonna create something real quick to press it on here. And then just to show you guys how it presses, how it heats. I don't have a heat gun to test the temperature, but I can already tell this is a good machine compared to the one that I already have. You can already tell that this is gonna be top notch for me anyway, because what I've been through with my other one. Okay, I'm going to create something to press really quick and clean up because I'm like all dusty and bleh, nasty. And fix everything because now I have to change some stuff around. I'm kind of OCD a little bit. I don't like things crooked and out of place. Drives me insane. Which is weird because I have four kids and you would think things would be out of place and crooked, but I don't like it. I don't like it. It drives me crazy. So anyway, if you like this video, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell to get more videos like this one, and leave any comments down below, questions you might have, And until then, I will see you literally in like a few minutes because I'm going to post another video of me pressing on this bad boy. And yeah, have some fun with it. I'm going to probably move it down a little bit more, switch it around. And I will be back. Until then, be safe, be well, peace and love, and I'll see you in a bit.